advice. Please silence announcements from Grayscope, Be Real, Canvas, SciChat, and G-Cal for tonight. And put some modern devices away, out of sight. Tonight's show will be streamed over a live video feed, so please refrain from using Wi-Fi so we can maintain a fast internet speed. And please, no flash photography during our show, or, like Iolanthe, the fairy queen will banish you, don't you know. But if the queen does banish you, because you are a mortal's bride, please take a moment to find the exits located at the theater side. Our fairy tale is 2 hours and 15 minutes long, with a 15-minute intermission to debate with your friends about your favorite song. Bathrooms are located on the ground floor, and while in line, follow Harvard, Gilbert and Sullivan on social media if you want to see more. Finally, after the show tonight is done, join us in the Horner Room for a post-show reception to have some fun. Now that you understand our theater scene, please rise for God Save the Queen.
King!
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 Thank you.
Thank you. She is now seven knots on her head at the bottom of that stream.
Yes, but when I banished her, I gave her all the pleasant places of the earth to dwell in. I'm sure I never intended that she should go and live at the bottom of the stream. It makes me feel perfectly wretched to think of the discomfort she must have undergone.
Think of the damp. And her chest was always delicate.
Frogs. Never shall enjoy any peace of mind until I know why Iolanthe went to live among the frogs.
Then why not summon her and ask her?
Why? Well, because if I laid eyes on her, I should forgive her at once.
Then why not forgive her? 25 years, it's a long time.
Think how he loved her.
Loved her? What was your love to mine? Why, she was invaluable to me. Who taught me to curl myself inside a buttercup? Iolanthe. Who taught me to swing upon a cobweb? Iolanthe. Who taught me to nestle in a nut shelter, gamble upon gossamer, to dive into a dewdrop? Iolanthe.
She certainly did surprising things.
I'll give her back to us, Radcliffe, for your sake, if not for ours.
I should be strong, but I am weak. I should be marble, but I am clay. The punishment has been heavier than I intended. I didn't mean that she should go and live at the bottom.
He was born soon after I left my husband by your royal command, but he does not even know of his father's existence.
How old is he?
24.
Oh, 24! Oh, and to look at you would think you had a son of 24. But that is one of the advantages of being immortal. We never grow old. Is he pretty?
He's extremely pretty, but he's inclined to be stout.
I see no objection to stoutness.
Moderation.
And what is he?
He's an Arcadian shepherd, and he loves Phyllis, a ward in Chancery.
A mere shepherd, and he hath a fairy?
He's a fairy down to the waist, but his legs are mortal.
Dear me!
Don't suppose I'm more curious than other people, but I confess I should like to see a person who is a fairy down to the waist, but whose legs are mortal.
Nothing easier, for here he comes!
Thank you. happy forever.
Well, we're to be married.
It's the same thing.
I suppose it is. But, oh, Strephon, I tremble at the step I'm taking. I believe it's penal servitude for life to marry a ward of court without the Lord Chancellor's consent. Besides, I'll be of age in 2 years. Don't you think you could wait 2 years?
2 years? Have you ever looked in the glass?
No, never.
Well, when you look in the glass, tell me if you think it reasonable. Hmm. Tell me, look at this, and tell me if you think it reasonable to expect me to wait 2 years.
Oh, no! Why, you're quite right. That would be asking too much. One must be reasonable.
Besides, all sorts of things can happen in 2 years. Why, you might fall in love with the Lord Chancellor himself by that time. As it were, half the House of Lords are sighing at your feet.
House of Lords are certainly extremely attentive.
Attentive? I should think they were. Why did 25 conservative peers come and shoot over your grass plot last autumn? And it could not have been the sparrows, no. And why did 25 liberal peers come and fish in your pond that was not the goldfish? No, no, the ladies are dangerous. If we're to be married, the sooner the better.
Thank you. Thank you.
and the mountains, they cry, you love this maiden? Take her, we command you. 'Tis written heaven by the bright barbed dart, which leaps forth into lurid light from each grim thundercloud. The very rain pours forth her sad and sodden sympathy. When coarse nature bids me, take thy love, shall I reply nay, but a certain Lord Chancellor forbids it? Sir, you are England's Lord High Chancellor.
Yes, I am.
But are you Lord Chancellor of the Beast? Are you Lord Chancellor of the Breeze? Of the Brooks? Are you Lord Chancellor of the Gales and the Fails? Are you king of the winds? Are you prince of thunderclouds?
No. That's a fine point. Not that I've met it before. But you see, my difficulty at the present moment is that there's no evidence before the court that the chorus nature has interested herself in this matter.
No evidence. You have my word for it. I tell you, she bade me take thy love.
No, you mustn't tell me what she told you. That's not evidence. Now, an affidavit from a thundercloud, or a few words under oath from the heavy shower, met with all the attention they deserve.
Have you really the heart to apply these prosaic rules of evidence to a case which bubbles over with poetical emotion?
Distinctly. I like to keep my duty strictly before my eyes, and it is to that fact that I owe my advancement to my present position.
Thank you.
Yeah.
protege of yours is playing the deuce with everything. Tonight is a second reading of his bill to throw the peerage open to competitive examination.
And he'll carry it, too.
Carry it? Of course he will. He's a parliamentary U-Haul. He carries everything.
Yes, if you please, that's our fault.
The deuce it is.
Yes, we influence the members and compel them to vote just as he wishes them to.
It's our system. It shortens the debates.
I think of what it all means. Well, the House appears with no grandfathers worth mentioning. The country must go to the dogs.
I suppose it must.
I don't want to say a word against brains. I have great respect for brains.
I often wish I had some myself.
But with the House of Peers composed entirely of persons of intellect, what's to become of the House of Commons?
I've never thought of that.
This comes of women interfering in politics. It just so happens that if there is an institution in Great Britain which is not susceptible of any improvement at all, it is the House of Peers.
Oh.
younger than himself.
Phyllis, my darling.
Phyllis, my own!
Don't! How dare you! Oh, but perhaps you're the two noblemen I'm engaged to.
I'm the other.
Well, then, my darling, my own. Well, have you decided which it's to be?
Not altogether. It's a difficult position, and it would be hardly delicate to toss up. On the whole, we'd rather leave it to you.
How could it possibly concern me? You are both earls, you are both rich, and you are both plain.
So we are. At least, I am.
So am I.
No, no.
I am very plain.
Well, perhaps you are.
There's really nothing to choose between you. If one of you would simply forego his title and distribute his estates amongst the Irish tenantry, why, then I should see reason for accepting the other.
Tallulah, are you prepared to make the sacrifice?
No.
Not even to oblige a lady?
Not even to oblige a lady.
Then the only question is, which of us shall give way to the other? Perhaps on the whole, she would be happier with me. I don't know. I may be wrong.
No, I don't know that you are. I really think she would. But the awkward part of the thing is that if you rob me of the girl of my heart, we must fight. And one of us must die.
It's a family tradition that I sworn to respect. And it's a difficult position, for I have very strong regard for you, George.
My dear Thomas.
George, you're very dear to me.
We were boys together. At least I was. If I were to survive you, my existence would be hopelessly embittered.
Then, my dear Thomas, you must not do it. I say it again and again. If it will have this effect upon you, you must not do it. No, no. If one of us is to destroy the other, let it be me.
Oh, no. No.
I guess by our boyish friendship, I implore you.
Well, be it so. But no, no. I cannot consent to an act that will crush you with unavailing remorse.
But it would not do so. I should be very sad at first. Oh, it would not be. But if we were off, I like you very much. But not perhaps as much as you, like me.
You're a noble fellow. With a telltale tear, you'll betray me. George, you are very fond of me, and I cannot consent to a week's uneasiness on my account.
My dear Thomas, it would not last a week. Whenever you lead the House of Lords on your demise, I shall take your place. Oh, my dear Thomas, it would not last a day.
I really hope you're not going to fight over me. That really wouldn't be worthwhile.
No, I don't think it is.
Nor I. The sacred ties of friendship are paramount.
Yeah. a shoulder to spare. You're not a regular, regular freaking young man. No wonder you won't be the best of the world. You need to get to this world. That's what we really like. We need to get to this world. But we are not going to be this world. We're not going to be this world. We're not going to be sleeping all night. The darkness of past.
When I'm gone.
say, my lady. I have not yet been informed which title your ladyship has pleased to select.
Well, I haven't quite decided yet. You see, I have no mother to advise me.
No, I do.
Yes, a young mother.
Not very, a couple of centuries or so.
Oh, she wears them.
She does. She's a fairy.
I beg your pardon, a what?
There's no longer any reason to conceal the fact. She's a fairy.
A fairy? Well, but that would explain a good many things. I suppose that means you're a fairy.
I'm half a fairy.
Which half?
Upper half, down to the waistcoat.
Oh, but dear me, there's nothing to show it.
Don't do that.
But why didn't you tell me this before?
I thought you'd take a dislike to me. But as it's all off, you may as well know I'm only half mortal.
But I would rather have half a mortal I do love than half a dozen I don't.
Please, go to your half dozen.
I hate him! Besides, please forgive me.
I don't think I ought to. Besides, all sorts of complications might arise. You see, my grandmother looks just as young as my mother, and so do all of my aunts.
I quite understand. Whenever I shall see you kissing a lady much younger than yourself, I shall know it's an elderly relative.
You will. Oh, then, Phyllis, I think you shall be very happy.
We won't wait long.
No, we might change our minds. Let's get married first.
And change our minds afterwards.
That's the usual course.
Died childless.
passingly added that I yielded to no one in my professional and private virtues. Now, this was a great point taken. I then endeavored to work upon my feelings. Conceive my joy when I distinctly perceived a tear glistening in mine own eye. And after severe struggle with myself, I most reluctantly, consented.
Kneel.
the legal mind are equal to the case. The matter really is quite simple. The insertion of a single word will do it. Let it stand that every fairy shall die who doesn't marry a mortal. There you are, out of your difficulty at once.
We like your humor, sir. Very well. Peri, Phyllis!
Present, ma'am.
In order to save my life, it is necessary to marry. Should you like to be a fairy guardsman?
Well, ma'am, I don't think much of the British soldier who will not ill-convenience himself to help a lady in distress.
You are a very brave fellow. You are a fairy from this moment. And you, my lords, what say you? Will you join our ranks?
Well, to all honor, now that the period is to be recruited entirely from persons of intellect, I really don't see what use we are down here.
None whatever.
Good. Then away we go to Fairyland.
Thank you.